And there's more tales at 4:15 tomorrow.
And don't forget to turn on to Teabag at 4:25.
Yes, I know.
And there's a new series of Do It at 4:50.
Yes, I was going to say that, actually, T-shirt. Mm. Actually, Norman, who's the editor of the Bellstone Monthly, is looking for a new assistant. Do you fancy, you know...
Who, me? No. I wouldn't mind working for the Ghostbusters, though.
Well, funny you should mention that, because they're on after the break.
Flying visit to McDonald's. Dropping some friends off first. Over.
Fancy a quick dip, chaps.
Volvo.
McNuggets away!
He really fell for that one.
I say, what happened to number six?
I think he's a bit chicken.
Once you taste Kellogg's start, you won't want to stop.
Come on, let's stick together.
Sing a song of six spots. The king, he gave a sigh. He wasn't even partial to blackbirds in a pie. But when the pie was opened, much to his surprise, his favourite Cadbury's buttons were right before his eyes.
Cadbury's buttons, dairy milk chocolate for beginners.
He rode into town on the 6:49. He was mean and hungry. There'd been trouble in town and he'd missed lunch. He made straight for the saloon, a blue one. Back home, his woman was fixing something special. Prize steak from the Bird's Eye Steakhouse. Big, meaty, and made with pure beef. A man could easily mistake it for steak. And then he just smiled. And headed off into the sunset to check his petunias. Bird's Eye Steakhouse. The bestest tasting meat in town.
Still mornings on in 25 minutes.
And remember to watch Teabag tomorrow.
Thank you, T-shirt. Still mornings on in 25 minutes, and it's the last in the present series, and we can find out what happened to Ben. Because at the end of last week's programme, there was a gunshot, and we're not quite sure what's happened to him. That's still morning at 4:45. First, though, it's the Ghostbusters.